Let us analyze the pressure exerted by a gas. As in the previous article, we already studied that gas exerts pressure on container walls by continuous collisions of its molecule. Now, here we are going to mathematically analyze the magnitude of pressure exerted by a gas. So, there is a container A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H in which there are gas molecules taken. And in this situation, say we consider one molecule of gas, which is of mass m dash, and moving with the speed v, which is generally taken as vrms in a particular direction. So, this speed, this velocity can be resolved into three directions, x, y and z, as vx, vy and vz respectively. If one by one we consider the three components of this velocity, say along x direction we assume this molecule of mass m dash is moving at a velocity vx. It moves. If we assume that other components are absent, it will be moving in x direction. It will strike the wall EFGH and it will rebound. As collisions are considered to be elastic, it will rebound with the same velocity vx. So, in this situation we can write in x direction, change in momentum due to one collision is, this can be written as delta px. The momentum of particle, the molecule in x direction is m dash vx and it will rebound with the same momentum but in opposite direction. So, change will be 2 m dash vx. And if we find out the time between two collisions, between two successive collisions on same wall, this can be easily considered. Say if the length of this container is L, its width is W and its height is H, then in x direction the molecule will travel a distance L, it will strike again and come back by traveling a distance L. So, total between two successive collisions it will cover a distance of 2L. So, time between two successive collisions delta T can be written as 2L by Vx. So, if this is the transfer of momentum or change in momentum due to a collision and this is the time between two collision, then we can write that due to just one collision, force exerted on wall EFGH is, this force exerted in x direction we can write, this can be written as delta px by delta t. It is just due to one collision. So, its magnitude will be, if you just substitute this, 2 gets cancelled out, it will be m dash px square by L. This is a force exerted due to one collision only. Similarly, if we find out the value of pressure on same wall due to one collision, which we have just taken, is, this can be written as pressure due to movement in x direction, it can be written as force divided by the area of this wall, and the surface area of this wall can be written as width multiplied by height, it is wh. So, if you substitute the value of this fx, this will be m dash vx square upon lwh. And LWH can be regarded as the total volume of container. So, this Px can be written as m dash Vx square divided by the volume. Just now, as we have calculated pressure on the wall in x direction, we can write down pressure in all the walls, pressure on all the walls in x, y, z direction. So, we can write, similarly, pressure on walls in x, y and z direction can be written as, here along x direction pressure on wall, as we have written, it is m dash vx square by the total volume. We can write pressure on wall in y direction as m dash vy square upon v, and pressure in z direction can be written as m dash vz square upon v. As pressure is a scalar quantity, we can easily find out the average pressure on container walls can be given as 1 by 3 of px plus py plus pz. As it is scalar, we can directly take out the scalar average. So, when you substitute the values, it will be 1 by 3 m dash by v into vx square plus vy square plus vz square, which can be written as vrms square. So, average pressure due to one collision, as we have calculated these pressures just due to one molecule, existence of one molecule, so it can be given as 1 by 3 m dash by v into vrms square, as we can write here vrms square is vx square plus vy square plus vz square, which we already discussed. Now, in this situation, if there are total n molecules in the container, total pressure can be given as, total pressure will be, say if there is the average pressure due to one molecule, it can also be written as PAV1. So, average pressure can be written as PAV1 multiplied by total number of molecules, because this is just due to one molecule. We substitute the values, it is 1 by 3 m dash by v vrms square multiplied by total number of molecules. And here m dash is mass of one molecule. We multiply the mass of one molecule with all the molecules. This will give us the total mass of gas. So, it can be written as 1 by 3 m by v multiplied by vrms square, where m is the total mass of gas which is taken in the container. As just now we have calculated, the average pressure due to all the molecules of gas is written as 1 by 3 m by v into vrms square. And mass upon volume can be written as density of gas. So, it can be written as 1 by 3 rho vrms square, where in this situation we can write, where rho is equals to m by v is the density of gas. This is actually the mass per unit volume of gas in the container. One more important relation we can deduce from here is P can be written as this. So, we can rearrange as 2 by 3 of half rho v square. Here, I have just multiplied and divided by 2. So, this 2 by 3 I have taken common. We talk about this half rho v rms square. Rho is the mass per unit volume. So, half mv square is the kinetic energy. So, this can be written as 2 by 3 E, where E is a half rho v rms square. We can write as the kinetic energy density of the gas. Kinetic energy density is just the kinetic energy per unit volume, because in half mv square here we are taking rho instead of mass. This is the mass per unit volume. So, this is the kinetic energy per unit volume of the gas, and this is the relation between the gas pressure and the kinetic energy density, which is also quite useful in various numerical analysis.